Spirit, 하나님, every single day. He prayed and he prayed with hopes of getting a daughter. Several months went by and countless prayers were said. It all boiled down to nothing. There wasn't even a sign of his dreams coming true. With much frustration, he lamented,
하나님, please, let me have a daughter.
Would you want her even if she's a fox?
Anything, anything for a daughter.
The man waited for a reply, but was only greeted by the sounds of cricket and the howling of wolf in the distance. Disappointed, the man traveled down the mountains and back to his house.
He was pregnant soon after his encounter with the spirit. There they were, gathered around the table ready for dessert. The man's wife laid down the pot of dessert. She couldn't wait to announce the good news. His prayers were heard. He's going to have a child, and it may very well be the daughter that he had always wished for. He was so happy that he had hugged his wife. After a tough time, the baby was finally born. The man was delighted for what he saw. It was a baby girl, beautiful as well. All along, he could only dream of this moment. But now, it is happening for real. His very own baby girl, right in the palms of his hand. The family then lived a harmonious and normal life. The man and his wife, along with his three sons, treated the only daughter of the family like a princess. Girl grew up healthy and soon she was 6 years old. During the night of her birthday, the family celebrated with joy. They couldn't believe how quickly she was growing up. Everyone seems to be enjoying themselves. Well, except for one. Celebration. It was really late into the night and everyone was asleep, except for the eldest son, who was awake to watch over the cows. The moon was at its fullest, finest, appearing as a whole, surrounded by brightly lit stars. Once in a while, breezes would sweep by and send shivers down his spine. Family gathered around the dining table and played their favorite traditional game. The eldest son then pulled his father to a corner to tell him what happened. Then rushed back to his room sadly. The father then summoned the second son.
Son, come here. Anything I can help you? Okay, son. Now listen carefully. I want you to keep your eye on my cow for tonight, for every night. Can you do that?
Sure.
That night, while the son was resting comfortably as he watches over the cow, all of a sudden, something dashed into the cattle shed. He went over to look and was horrified by what he saw. Frightened, he ran back home and quickly went to bed.
Enough! Same stupid thing I heard from your oldest brother.
same outrageous story he heard from his eldest son. He did not want to hear any more of it and promptly sent his second son back to his room. The man, unsatisfied, the man then called his youngest son to keep watch over the cattle shed from that night onwards. Just like before, everything was peace and quiet. Then, the full moon came. While the young son was unavailingly slacking under the tree, at one point, he heard a loud ruckus at the cattle shed. He went to peep. Stumbled upon an unsettling sight. There it was, a figure with its back facing him, crouched beside a cow, lying motionless on the ground. Using its teeny hands, the figure ripped open the cow's torso and pulled the intestines out, eating them one by one. However, the younger son was unshaken. He crept forward, one step at a time, but accidentally kicked over a water line on the ground. The startled figure slowly turned its head. Oh my god! It's their sister! The next morning, the younger son had to report to his father about the night before.
What shall I do? Shall I tell you the truth? If I tell you the truth, that demons might kill me, murder me. And my father, you scold me just like my other brothers. What shall I do now?
being thrown out of their house. The first two sons were no more than beggars. They wandered around and finally stopped at an old temple. After 1 month of intense training, they decided to return home.
They reached home. They found the yard unkempt. There were weeds overgrown everywhere. The once illustrious paper panels on the door were also in tatters. Not a single soul was around. No one except their sister.
Where is father? And where is our youngest brother?
Trust you. 5 minutes.
Are you sure they went into the mountains?
Yes, they are.
Brother, I think we should go to mother. Let's go.
Papa, please don't go and stay with me.
They were suspicious, but still they drank the water.
they doing?
Staggered as he ran away from the fox. In no time, the fox caught up with him. He threw the blue bottle, and in a loud splash, a vast lake appeared, trapping the fox. Left in the end. When the dust had settled,